Young men should have a voice. Young men should have role models. Young men must have support to be successful. This was said by a young woman. Let's talk about it. Hey, my people, welcome to the RK3 show. Yep, it's episode 31 and we're rocking it. I'm excited about today's episode. But before we begin, I want to direct you back to the last episode, number 30, where we spoke about imposter syndrome. Based on the feedback I received, it was a good episode. So go check it out. You'll be glad you did. And after you listen, let me know what you think about it by going to my voicemail. RobertKennedy3.com/voicemail. That's RobertKennedy3.com/voicemail. Hey, listen, we are going to jump right into the show today. My guest for today is Sonnie Njau. She is an amazing young lady from Kenya who is the founder and CEO of a program called Men Impact Change in Baltimore, Maryland. She believes that all young men must have a chance at success, but they need our support. So she started a national organization to do just that. Sonnie has a story. Let's tell it. Today, she is Sonnie Njau, who is the founder and CEO of the Men Impact Change Organization. She's a top 40 under 40 Business Journal Award recipient. She is amazing, y'all. And I just want you to get to know her a little bit today. Sonnie, how are you?
I am doing well, Robert. Thank you so much for this opportunity. It is so great to be here. And I really appreciate you for that.
Excellent. So first of all, I didn't ask you. I want to make sure I got your last name right.
Okay.
Go ahead. Sonnie Njau.
Yeah. So my last name is Njau. So the N is silent. So it's N-J-A-U. So the N is silent. And I also wanted to mention, I was actually the top 40 under 40 influential under Black Business Review. So
wow.
I just wanted to point that out.
Excellent. Thank you so much. So one of the things that's very unique about you, and one of the reasons I wanted to have you on, is because you are a woman, obviously, right? And you have an organization called Men Impact Change. Now,
correct.
I've seen men or male mentorship programs, and I've seen, and all of them are men kind of helping other boys proceed or move forward. But you are passionate about male mentorship. What caused that?
Absolutely. So, Robert, what people don't know about me is that I grew up being surrounded by boys. I am the only daughter in a family of two boys. I have two younger brothers. And also my mom is the only daughter surrounded by five brothers himself. And my dad, you know, him and I were very close while growing up as well. Now, when growing up, I had so many opportunities myself as a female and also other females around the community. We had a lot of great opportunities, like coaching opportunities, mentorship opportunities. We were exposed to great information. But I realized that the same was not happening to my brothers and all the men in the community as well. And I felt like, you know, as they're growing up, they are lacking that mentorship. And while the society is really expecting a lot from them. And what really triggered Men Impact Change to be founded was back in 2014, where there was some violence happening in my continent, several countries in Africa. And I realized it was not only happening there, but it was also happening right here in America, where women were being violated publicly. Now, I realized that, you know, a lot of times the reaction was, how dare they? How dare they? Why would they do such a thing? And I realized that if you, I thought about the situation and realized that these men have not really, they didn't have the right kind of training. Most of them grew up with no father figures in their lives or with absentee fathers. So they were not really taught about, the masculine values. The kind of values that they were taught was from out in the streets. And so I realized that this was something that was missing in the community. That's how men impact change was actually triggered.
Wow. So that's very interesting because, I mean, we're in a society right now. We've got Me Too movements. We've got the glass ceiling that we talk about. And the general thought is that women just don't have as many opportunities as men. And so typically when you find a woman fighting for a cause, it's really to bring other women up. But here you are seeking to go behind that and find out how you can really solve some of the challenges that men experience. So tell me a little bit, as you started this organization, was there any pushback that you received? Like, why, Sonnie, are you starting an organization for men fighting for women?
Yes, I had a lot of pushbacks. I had a lot of pushback. A lot of people said, you're a woman, why don't you go out and start a boys organization, or I'm sorry, a girls organization or a women's organization. And I mean, I just had to be resilient because I knew that, we are not fighting against each other. You know, it's a family unit. If you are supporting the girl child, we also have to do the same thing for our young men. And, especially in the Black community, we will find that there's a lot of issues and the system is not really supporting our young men. And we cannot really always wait for the government to help us. We have to do something ourselves and build our own systems to really support the young men in the community.
That's awesome. So you said this started out in 2014 and you recently had your 5-year celebration. This year, I had the honor of being one of your honorees
for
leadership. And I just felt amazing about that. And I wasn't 100% sure what I'd do to be recognized, but it felt really good to be recognized, right?
Right, so, absolutely.
Yeah, so what is for you... What has been the key for you in the success of this organization so far?
What has been the key is that this is something that is very, very much needed in the community. So people are really supportive. As much as I've gotten a pushback, actually the support has been much, much more. It's something that is really needed. It's a problem that we are solving in the community. As you saw last year, we had almost 400 people at the ceremony. This year we're also expecting the same because it's our 5th year anniversary. So we are expecting to do the same as well. And as you mentioned, that you did not know if you were doing anything that was worth being recognized. And I told you, yes, you are. Because I always give an example with the current president. He is out there, using social media to advance his own values that are not very supportive or they're not appealing to our community. So we have to do the same thing as well. If we see something good that is being done in the community, we have to be as loud as possible. There's a quote by Martin Luther that says, the reason why evil triumphs is because good people are silent. So our platform is meant to talk about those stories and to those stories from men that would otherwise not really have a platform. Those men that work very hard behind the scenes to make things happen. We want to make sure that the community knows that, hey, there's Robert Kennedy that is doing, has been so consistent, so resilient, doing some great impact in the community. And what that does is that once people see that they are great men doing something, then it kind of all those negative stories that are going on, people are not going to focus on that anymore. They're going to start focusing on the great things that these great men like yourselves are doing. And something else is there are so many young men that do not have positive role models in their community. So once they see great men like yourself being honored, then they will have that inspiration to really emulate you and to take after you. So that's the whole purpose of the organization.
communication, motivation, leadership, and more. You're listening to the RK3 Show.
Hey there, listen up. Are you enjoying the episodes? Are you getting great information from the guests? Well, we need your support to help the show grow. You can contribute to the show by going over to patreon.com/TheRK3Show. That's P-A-T-R-E-O-N, patreon.com/TheRK3Show. And now, back to the show. In doing something like this, you've been doing it for 5 years, and
right.
I know from personal experience that it takes a lot to make this happen. So tell me a little bit about the team that you've got around you. Is it all women, or tell me a little bit about the team that you've got supporting you?
Yes. So we have three chapters for Men Impact Change. We have a chapter in Texas. We have a chapter in Washington State, in Seattle. And then the headquarters is right here in Maryland. So as far as the team, we have teams all around the United States. We have a very strong team of about 12. And I mean, it's all mixed up, but I would say the men are more than you saw them last year. They're more than women. We have three women, including myself, and the rest are young men, you know, men of all ages as well that are part of this organization.
Excellent. So you talked about young men and them seeing some of these role models. Do you have any success stories or stories that you can share with us about things that have happened or experiences that young men have gone through as a result of being connected with the Men Impact Change organization?
Absolutely. So one of the things that we do is we have an internship, a 6-month internship program where we support the young men that are trying to nurture their talents or nurture their passions, their career passions as well. So we have one success story from one of the interns that was with us last year. He came to us and said, "Hey, Sonny, I'm really looking for an opportunity where I could have, you know, have public speaking opportunities where I could speak." And I told him, "Absolutely, be part of the internship program. We are going to walk you through the process. We are going to connect you with great men." We connected him with Dr. Myers from Baltimore. We connected him with, you know, other men in the community. He saw what they were doing. We also took him around to different states. We gave him an opportunity in Pennsylvania and another speaking opportunity at Howard University. And from that experience, he was able to really work on his public speaking skills. And I'm sure you saw at the honor ceremony last year, we had a panel for young men. So one of them was an intern. It was his first time ever to have that speaking opportunity in an audience of over 350. So that's a great success story. If you want another one, it's from another young man, 28-year-old, who, when we first had the honor ceremony, came in as an attendee. And he spoke to me and said, "Sonny, you know, this is really great that you're doing. You know, I've always wanted to start a business. I'm really passionate about fashion and design, and I really don't know where to start." And, you know, through Men Impact Change, he found partnerships, he found ways of building his business. And the following year, he came in not as an attendee, but as a vendor.
Wow.
So he was able to launch his own company. We supported him, we gave him the exposure and the platform as well.
Excellent. So when we were talking earlier, you mentioned that there was a little bit of a significance between by when you hold the event, and you hold it in November, typically.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about that.
So we strategically host this ceremony in the second weekend of November. And that's because a lot of people don't know this, but the same way March is the month to celebrate the accomplishments of girls and women, November is the month to celebrate the accomplishments of men.
Wow.
And it's an it's internationally recognized. It's been going on for years and years. But now we are doing it strategically to make sure that this is a men's month and we have to recognize all these great men in our community.
Awesome. Awesome. So I'm still just really settling in on the fact, and we're going right back to the beginning, that you are a woman who's leading an organization pointed at men. Are there other women who have influenced you and that you admire that are doing great work in the area of in this area?
Not really. You know, with the male a male organization, but I've actually seen men, women really supporting the young men or the men in general. One of some of them are we all know about the Black Lives Matter movement.
Right.
That was started by three powerful women.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say that is one of them. But as far as any other woman, like particularly working towards a male organization, I can't think of anyone right now, but I do have women that are doing other things in other areas that inspire me to keep pushing and to keep going no matter, you know, the challenges.
Wow. So you're a pioneer in this area. Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, we have to, I'll do a little bit of digging and see if there is someone out there, you know, but yeah, not in, I haven't really seen someone with, you know, male organization yet.
Excellent. All right. Well, so tell us a little bit more about where people can find you, how they can get connected and maybe support your organization.
Absolutely. So you can find us everywhere on social media, Instagram, Facebook, at Men Impact Change. That is M-E-N Impact. That is I-M-P-A-C-T Change, C-H-A-N-G-E. I do also have to mention that we have the honor ceremony coming up in November, November 16th. This will be a very, very special year because it's the 5th year anniversary since the organization was founded. So we are very much expecting great things to happen. And I can tell you that, you know, if you are a business owner as well, something I do have to mention is that we have a lot of CEOs, founders, co-founders, board members of various organizations that come in under the same roof. Also, it's a very diverse organization. As you saw last year, we had people from all you know, cultures, all nationalities. You know, we had Ghana represented there. We had various African countries represented. We had Caucasians. We had people that flew in from other states as well. So it's a very dynamic organization. And if you're trying to connect with like-minded people, trying to connect with people that are shifting the culture, this is the place that you need to be. Something else, one of our other successes that I have to mention is we had a couple years ago, we had two gentlemen that we honored under the entrepreneurship category. One of them was a Will Holmes. I'm pretty sure you know Will Holmes, locally here in Baltimore. The other gentleman that we honored under the same category was Startup Africa, the founder of Startup Africa, who is originally from Kenya. And after honoring them, they really connected, they built partnerships. And for the first time ever, Will Holmes went to Africa, you know, to work together and collaborate. And that collaboration has been going on for years. So again, the platform that we are giving the men is, you know, they always say iron sharpens iron. So right. When you come there, you're going to find another man who is going to spark something inside of you to keep on pushing in whatever area you're pushing in whatever career you're in. You're going to find that support system as well. Now, the organization is not, I mean, the event is not only for men, it's women come in as well. So it's the whole community coming in to support the great men. And just like Black Girls Rock, we all know about Black Girls Rock. I mean, Black Girls Rock honors women, honors girls that are great, doing great. Men Impact Change honors great men that are doing great in the community. And we hope that everyone will join in and support and push, you know, keep on pushing and supporting us as much as possible so that we can continue impacting change and building the legacy of change in our community.
None of us is a success without help. Sometimes we start out a little further behind the starting line because of the hand society has dealt us, and so we need to grab the hands of mentors, leaders, and willing achievers in order to move forward. If you've been helped or been a recipient of help on your way to success, then I want to empower you today to reach back and help someone, help a young man, help move them forward to success, and that way, leave a legacy. That's all, folks. Head to the show notes to grab the links and resources from this episode. Then go over to Apple Podcasts to leave a ranking, rating, and review for the show. Also, head over to the other major podcast outlets, wherever you listen to podcasts. I hope you had fun today. I hope you learned something. Most of all, I hope you were compelled to jump out of your comfort zone and share your story. If I can be helpful to you with that process, let me know by hopping over to robertkennedy3.com. Hey, y'all, don't forget, everything that happens to you in life is your stuff is your story, and your story deserves a stage. I'm Robert Kennedy III, RK3, and you've been listening to... The RK3.